Hey everyone, I am so glad that you are joining us again today. We're going to have a good time diving into God's definition of patience and how we can help our kids activate that within themselves. I don't know if your kids struggle with patience ever. I don't know if, as parents, we sometimes give our kids plenty of opportunities to develop this. And we have...
Even with us.
We have plenty of opportunities to ignore those opportunities and see them as challenges or disrespect, or and then we go straight to punishing the fruit of it without going to the root of it. Does that make sense?
We're not speaking from experience, of course. This is something we're currently dealing with and also currently teaching in root, which ironically seems to be the trend with the Lord. Whenever we are teaching something, we usually are also walking through that something in order to be equipped to apply our faith, our knowledge, the wisdom the Holy Spirit has led us in as revelation in action. So it doesn't just be come empty words that right. We are teaching other people. We get to experience it and walk it out. And we're currently walking it out, actually with all three, truly, on different things, right?
Yep.
And then in turn, teaching how we're learning to what we're going to talk about, patience, what it really means in the Bible, how to help them have it as well.
Okay, comically, pause for a sec. How many of you have ever struggled with patience while trying to teach your kids to be patient? Anybody ever? Yeah.
Oh, how about
all
this?
Of you feel
you
like
respond you're nice to your brother. yeah.
Good time.
And
you
respond nice to your brother, said like that.
That's why we're talking about both patience for ourselves and for our kids, because what, even though you may teach them the right way, wow, did you see my hand like totally disappeared? That's trippy. Even though we may teach that, we also have to live it in order for them to really catch it.
Yeah.
So,
but it's not as hard as you think.
No.
And we live in a society that patience has, if not completely, almost completely dwindled away.
Mm-hmm.
The gift of patience, the life of patience, the expectancy of patience on oneself while expecting it of another.
Exactly.
It's quite amazing. So
we
do not want to raise our kids to expect patience from everyone else and yet do none of that fruit or bear none of that fruit ourselves. And we really are in a society that is doing that today. I expect everyone else to have patience for my situation while I have none for yours.
Well, that was one of the big themes in the youth group that I grew up in was we should never judge other people by their actions and ourselves by our intentions, which is what we see so many people doing right now.
Yeah, you should really write that down. Don't judge others by their actions and yourself by your intentions.
Because we all mean to do good, and some, you have that fleeting thought pop in your head, you're like, okay, and then you judge yourself as, you know, I was really going to do that, I even thought about it, but I just didn't. And yet, you judge your kids, or your spouse, or your in-laws, or whoever, by their actions, and bring the gauntlet, and try to snap things
and
back
into
place.
And don't get me wrong, the Bible's very clear, we can't possibly know their intentions. But that should also mean we can't know their intentions, which means we can't assume good or bad. What is important is that we remain in patience. And we're going to talk about what that is today and how to make it real, both for yourself and your family. So let's get started. I found this. And this just, oh, look at my, okay. Oh, it's like the Terminator. Oh, I'm really a
That's
robot.
That's kind of funny.
Okay. So check this out. This says, all the art of living lies in a fine mingling of letting go and holding on. So I thought that was perfect for this because we're going to talk about what is it you let go of and what is it you hold on to.
Yep.
Right? So what a quote. The quote is from Havelock Ellis. Ellis family.
I like it. Ah, I like it.
Okay.
All right. So let me start off with this because this might put your hearts at ease. This is not something you have to strive for. This is not something you have to work really hard to develop. The Bible does not call these push-ups. Fruit of the Spirit as fruit of humans, fruit of Christians, fruit of the soul,
of the flesh.
Fruit of those that work hard enough they can actually achieve these things. It's fruit of the Spirit. And that's why each week as we're teaching this in Bible Academy, we're hitting Zechariah 4:6, reminding the kids that it's not by force nor by strength, but by my Spirit, says the Lord Almighty.
Thank you,
we got to remember that. It's not by our own efforts that we have achieved any of this.
Mm-hmm.
Our salvation was not by our own efforts. Being filled with Spirit wasn't by our own efforts. Nothing, almost nothing, I should say, in the Bible is talking about us doing enough to earn our position with God, earn His...
There are things we can do to earn rewards.
Yes.
But we accomplish those things by abiding in Him and obeying His commands.
If we really
There is nothing we can do to earn salvation again, as that, as well as healing, as well as provision, as well as so many other things, have already been completely purchased by Christ.
I don't know. I'd go as far to say, though, as if we're tapping into the Spirit and who He is within us,
we'll be producing the
that's
Spirit.
What will get us to do that.
And so,
earn the rewards. And so, it's really Him giving a promise, Him making the way for it to happen, Him doing it through us, and then we get the rewards out of it. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Let's see. We said we're going to talk about patience, and we haven't got there yet, and we're 6.5 minutes in. So let's talk about patience. Patience. What? How is God's patience different?
I have to look. So I've got to share this because we have our freebie at rootbible.com. You can get the freebie this month, and there's a fruit page where it divides Greek and Hebrew up, right? And on that page is John 15:5, and the word abide is used in John 15:5, mm-hmm. Or in John, so many times, because it's talking about apart from Him, we can do nothing. If we don't abide in the branch, forget about it. Just be cut off, because you're not going to be producing fruit. So there is no way to produce fruit apart from the vine. That means soul, body, actions that are not directly abiding with Christ are not producing spiritual fruit. So this is what blew my mind. I looked up, those who abide in Christ will bear much fruit. So I looked up John 15. I'm like, abide. What really does that mean? So I look it up in the Strong's. In the Greek, it means meno. In this particular, whatever, meno. Men, oh, no, that's right. Meno. Okay. Anyway.
I don't know my Greek.
To remain, to abide, not to depart, to continue to be present. So what we're talking about, right? Okay, the persons in order to survive or live. And he talks about that in John. Hmm. Literally, your life will be cut off if you are not abiding in the vine. Which you're like, what? That doesn't sound like a loving God. Yes, it does. Because He knows the only life that produces good fruit is one that abides with Him. And he says that means literally you are relying on Him for every breath of everything. That means full identity is in this vine. It's not, I think I'll grow a great, a great apple today. No, you're in the vine. You're going to grow what that vine is growing when you're abiding in the vine. So I thought, oh, that's really cool. Well, let's look up what patience is in the Greek. Are you ready for this? I'm going to murder it. Hupomon. Oh, wait, I can push play. Anyway, I won't do it right now. Okay, you know what it means? Remaining in or behind, right? And another one is remain with or endure, right? So it's the same thing, remain with. So I was like, so patience can only come, and the Greek shows us this plainly, by remaining. And you know what word they use there to explain remain? Meno. Which is the word that meant abide. So I'm like, patience cannot happen apart from the vine.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, what's the vine? The vine is Christ. He has accomplished everything. He has already conquered any situation with your kids, any situation with your spouse, any situation at work, anywhere that you would need to draw patience, He has already conquered it. So when you are remaining Hubanamon or whatever, or abiding meno in the vine, then you don't have to worry about it. The patience has already been sent ahead of time, like all the nutrients in that vine that produces the fruit. This isn't like, oh, give me patience. I mean, you can ask him, talk to him, commune with him. He's your friend. He's your Lord. That's fine. But he says, oh, just get with me. Because that is where it is. That is where, when you abide, when you remain, when you get your very life from me, it just flows out of you. It's not an effort. It's not a struggle. It's not a strive. Mm-hmm. And I loved that those two words just went bloop.
That's super fun.
I know. I couldn't wait to share it with you guys. It's a little exciting for me because it's just that reminder of, though we hear it, when you rediscover it as revelation, fresh, it just comes to life in you.
It's, yeah, and that's one of the things I'm super excited that we're going to be talking about at the revival. We're speaking and helping the kids and even some of the youth step into encountering God and everyday life. And so we're actually going to be in the Cincinnati area. Anybody in the Cincinnati area, give me a big thumbs up or a heart. Check out this website. We'd love to have you and your kids join because there's stuff for the whole family. Most of the time, everyone's going to be together, but the kids and the teens will come with us for some periods of time. But it's really about helping whole families step into revival.
Oh my
step
gosh,
into
I'm
what
so
God
excited
has.
Because it's here's the thing: patience will need to be had. We believe that the root of revival is getting the families to experience revival together again. Mm-hmm. Not always dividing them up, not sending them in their different directions, but having them learn how to make revival real together in the church, at home. This is mind-blowing exciting. And why do I say you need patience? Because we have been church taught.
Wait,
that
pause
you
for
don't
a second.
Have a crying baby.
I want to make a statement on your last point before you go on and make four more.
You talked about it.
I haven't got there yet.
Oh, sorry.
So one of the things we're going to talk about at this revival is going to be that it doesn't take an hour-long worship set to get into the Spirit.
Well, I was going to talk about that. I just wanted to say, you know, it also doesn't take no noise in the sanctuary.
Right.
That's why it takes
He's
patience.
Not that, if your God is so weak and so fickle,
your view of God,
that he cannot handle any slight disturbances,
or distractions.
Then he is not the one from the Bible. Look at what Jesus had. He had storms going and he's sleeping.
People laughing at him, making fun of him.
Families throwing kids at him so much that the disciples are like, give him a break. Leave him alone for a second. And Jesus, what? Rebukes the disciples. That's not a God that needs perfect
Take
silence.
Take those children
the perfect
out. No, don't
song,
get me wrong.
Everything to be
you
exact.
Also, if you've got a crying baby in the front row, I mean, we all, like, who's, like, really, you know, needs a moment.
And side
of course
note,
you're going to take your baby out of the sanctuary. That's
don't feed
different.
The baby in the sanctuary. Just for those of you, that's just awkward if you're on stage.
Okay. You can feed your baby in the sanctuary. They have cool stuff now, like what I use. We're talking about crying babies or kids making noises, or maybe they're coloring next to you, or maybe you have to pick up a pencil that was dropped. That doesn't mean it has removed you from the Spirit. And that's exactly what we'll be teaching the kids this week is you are currently fully in the natural. Are we ready? We're going to pray in the Spirit and we're going to be in the Spirit just as fast and authentically as we are in the natural. So
and
ready?
When
Let's do it.
And when you're in the Spirit, patience happens naturally. Mm-hmm. A fruit tree does not have to strive exceptionally hard and to force fruit out. We have an apple tree at the lake cabin that we stay at, my great grandma's lake cabin. And yes, it is as old as it sounds. There's an apple tree that has not been pruned, has not been fertilized, has not been watered, and has not nothing. It is just
and still
there, and it still bears fruit every year. Mm-hmm. I'd love to see what it would look like if it was pruned.
You want to know why it bears fruit every year?
Fertilized.
Because we go there every year, and
That's
we pray
true.
On that land, and we declare the Lord of that land is Jesus.
Things thrive there unusually well.
Yes, and that is why. I will just tell you that land's been dedicated to the Lord by our family many times.
But you're killing my point.
The idea is that you're not going to plant an apple tree and expect something different.
Yep.
And if you're rooted in the vine, then the fruit that you produce won't look different than Christ. And no matter how much you justify it, if it is different than Christ, then you are pulling it from somewhere else. And the Bible calls that dead works or yucky fruit in our case, right? Mm-hmm. And your kids don't have to deal with that when it comes to patience.
So how do you know if you yourself are walking in Holy Spirit patience or man's patience? Because we all have a extension, we have a supply of patience within us.
Naturally.
But you see it in the unsaved. They can be patient for a while. So how do you know if you're tapping into the Spirit's patience or if you're doing it with just the world's version? And so here's a couple big differences. One, obviously, the Holy Spirit patience kicks in when regularly you'd start to lose it. You would know if you're not losing it, and you kind of have that thought. I actually had that this morning. A couple days ago, I was getting so frustrated while I was working on something. And then today, I was doing the exact same thing, but I was just kind of in the Spirit. I was worshiping, I was praying, and things just seemed to flow. And I realized afterwards, I'm like, you know, I punched out the same thing with joy and peace and patience in my life that I did not have a couple days ago. What was the difference? I was doing it with Him. Yeah. Not belting out worship songs and everything, just being connected. So there's one. The fruit of the Spirit, patience, isn't hard. It happens naturally. When you're trying to put on patience, that's when it gets hard. Picture a kid waiting for his parent, aka you and I, to stop talking after church. They're patient, then their patience starts to wane thin.
Dwindle.
And then it comes to an end. And it gets really hard for them to stay patient. So that would be natural patience.
Another good one is patience in the upper room while they're waiting for the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
I mean, so many people left. How would you like to be in that group? Like, oh man, I'm bored. I'm out of here. I don't think it's ever coming what He promised. You know, how would you like to be in the group that left?
We did some research and it was patience. From what we can tell, it was about 7 to 9 days that they had to wait in the upper room, and they went from 500 people to 120. That's a big dip.
Yeah, of lack of patience. So you gotta remember, not everyone's gonna be operating in this, but that doesn't mean it gives us a free pass. That means when we dwell in Christ or abide in Christ, we're going to bear much fruit, and it's not going to be difficult. How can you notice whether or not you're out of the fruit? I believe it's because your reactions will be reactions and not responses. Anytime I know that I'm not responding from the Spirit, it's a reaction. So stop yelling at your brother, or will you stop it? That's, you know, whatever. Not, hey buddy.
An intentional response.
How you just talked to your brother, does that sound like it's coming from your spirit or your flesh? That is a response. Not a reaction. That's how I can easily determine whether or not I am responding out of my spirit or out of my flesh. Not because I have to strive, not because I have to learn to do this, but rather when I abide in Christ as knowing more than me, as accomplishing more than me, as being king over me. When I abide in that, then He's going to have the proper response, not Kate's flesh or soul reaction.
The other I would say for patience would be the natural patience is rooted in a trust in yourself, knowing you can punch through this. I can make this happen. I'm just going to stay diligent. That can be a source of patience, relying on yourself, or it could be patience because of what's it, love of other people's comments. You don't want to look bad in front of someone else, and so
you
choose
approval.
To be patient and
you're a people
kind,
pleaser.
Courteous, right? And so both are rooted in self.
Yeah, like your patience around everybody but your family. That usually means that is flesh and soul patience, not spiritual patience. I've been there.
Because you want to look good.
I bet every mom has been there. Oh, we have amazing patience at church and at the store, and our responses are so calm, you know? Mm-hmm. And then we get home and we're like, meh, like, here comes the soul, do-do-do-do, right? You know, like, no, it's about He leads me first at home, then it's going to be a cinch out there.
patience of that comes from the fruit of the Spirit, that reliance is completely on Him, knowing that He's going to take good care of you, knowing that He has the best plan for you and for your kids. And that as we rely on Him, He's going to be faithful to guide us into the things that our kids need to know or need to experience or need to be coached through. And He's going to give you the words for it. And so if we just rely on Him, He's going to be a way better parent through us than we ever could be. And so we just need to pull back, let go, release ourselves, and let Him flow through. Yeah. And so that, I would say, is one of the biggest, if you can pause and do some self-evaluation, am I being patient because of what other people might think, or patient because I know I can work through this in my own power? Or am I being patient because I'm fully relying on God to do in a situation what I can't figure out?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So write that down. You can say this to yourself and you can say this to your kid. Am I reacting out of my flesh or soul, or am I responding out of my spirit? And yes, your soul's got to catch up. Your mind needs to be renewed to my spirit leads me, not you.
Mm-hmm.
And that means it's going to take a natural choice to abide in the Spirit. Okay, we're not saying remove the natural altogether. No, but we're saying it's not an effort outside of Jesus, respond through me.
Yeah.
I am not reacting out of my soul today. I lean into you. I worship you. There's never, never a time that's not good to pray in the Spirit. Mm-hmm. To sing psalms and hymns to Him, to just be praising Him all day long, while cooking, while changing a diaper. Well, I mean, there is literally no time during the day that is not good to be. I wake up singing songs or thanking Him for things, and I go to sleep doing that, and all day long. Now, did my soul have to learn to lean into my spirit to do that? Yes, but now it's just literally second nature to abide.
Mm-hmm.
And when I don't abide, that's unnatural. So when I respond out of my soul or my flesh, it's like, oh, that was awful. That was awful, awful, awful. Like, that does not belong there, right? And that's not condemnation. That's conviction of how much better is it to be where there's fruit, to be where there's the King who leads and guides so well.
It goes against your real nature as a Christian because we've been made completely new.
Right.
And so, yeah.
Patience. Anyway. So we're not reacting, we're responding. Our flesh and soul don't get to react. Our spirit gets to respond. And that's how we know we dwell in patience.
We got to cut this off. I see we've gone for 22 minutes already. So what I want to do is talk a little bit about becoming a partner with Root Bible. I'm going real fast. Did you know Root Bible is a non-profit, 501c3, and is set up a lot of the same ways as a lot of schools? So I know you probably know this, the schools, Christian schools, a portion of their money that they need each year comes from tuition, but not all, not even close. Actually, the Bible school we went to, their tuition only covers 30% of expenses. And that's kind of how Root is set up, because we want to make sure families
can do it
anywhere, can do this. And so right now, at the time we're live here, it's $12 for a whole family. That means we're paying
We're
doing
high school.
A preschooler teacher live, interactive with your kids each week. Elementary kids, junior high, senior hires, all live, all interactive. None of it's pre-recorded. It's them calling on and pulling out the fruits of the Spirit.
And hearing
pulling
the,
out the
voice
gifts of
the
Spirit,
Lord and sharing what they hear.
And so we have that. We have a website and all the parent tools that we create and things like this that you're watching. And there's so much that really, if you think about it, $12, it doesn't even get close. So we would love to have you partner with us. And some of you that are really believing in this, you may want to go all the way and just do a scholarship for kids. Scholarship for a whole family to grow spiritually together this year. This would be an amazing opportunity. You can designate a family that you want to bless with this, and they can have access to all the live classes, all the parent tools, all the online trainings, all of that.
All the mini lessons we're all getting the, to, we oh, promise.
So excited about those.
They are so good. They're taped. It's just they need edited. And we have, and it takes so much time on editing. But these are little snippets that just teach what is salvation. What is reading your Bible supernaturally? Who mm-hmm. is the Holy Spirit? Little tidbits that you can watch in 3 minutes or less.
Yep.
And just allow that to supplement your day and help your kids yep. really
encourage. We've actually had some families do it, and then they enroll their family, and then they scholarship either a great friend family of theirs or even relatives. So we have some cousins that all do class together because the one parent scholarshiped the other family in
to
root, and it's super, super fun. So you can designate it or you can just leave it open. Right. And so as people come to us and say, hey, we'd love to be part of Root, we can have that funds available to them for them just to join for free, which is our heart. We want to see everyone grow together spiritually as a family.
Right.
So that's my little plug. I'm so excited. We're still going after 100 partners.
The Lord told him that we weren't allowed to not say that today. So
it's true.
We said it. And we believe in what he's called us to do. And we hope you will too, so much that you want to partner. So pray about mm-hmm. it. Let us know. Let's pray and let's get out of here.
Let's do it.
All right. You praying?
Sure. Holy Spirit, help us today. Help us to tap into the fruit of the Spirit and let you live through us today more than ever before, not so that we can be glorified, but to bring glory and honor to the Father.
Yes.
And God, I thank you for sending the Holy Spirit, who is our great helper, allowing us to live like we could never live on our own, allowing us to represent you like we never could. And I ask that you would teach us how to stay abiding in the vine, connected with you all day long. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen. All right. Thanks for joining us. We love y'all. Message us. Make a comment if you need yes. prayer. We love all the messages coming in. We respond to them all. Mm-hmm. So please keep them coming. We love praying for you. We love locking arms and being the kingdom body he's called us to be.
Yes.
All right.
All right.
God bless.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.